So here are the two crucial ingredients. I have many features available to me, but I hypothesize that there's a smaller number of features that are actually driving the patterns in the data. And then what I do is I take that knowledge and I try making a composite feature that more directly probes the underlying phenomenon. These composite features are what we'll be talking about in this lesson. They're called principal components, and it's an extremely powerful algorithm. In this lesson, we'll mostly talk about it in the context of dimensionality reduction, how you can use principal component analysis, or PCA, to bring down the dimensionality of your features, to turn a whole bunch of features into just a few. It's also a very powerful standalone method in its own right for unsupervised learning, and I'll give you some of my favorite examples of that in the latter half of this lesson. It's going to be really cool. So here's an example of what PCA is, transforming from square footage plus number of rooms into a single variable that roughly tracks the size of the house. So let's suppose this is my training data. I have the square footage on the x-axis and the number of rooms on the y-axis. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw in the principal component. It will look something like this. I know this looks like a regression at this point, but it's not. And here's why. With a regression, what you're trying to do is you're trying to predict an output variable with respect to the value of an input variable. Here we're not really trying to predict anything. We're trying to come up with a direction in the data that we can project our data onto while losing a minimal amount of information. So here's what that means. Once I've found my principal component, once I have the direction of this vector, of this line, and just go with me for now that it exists. We'll come back to how we find it in a little bit. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of my data points and I'm going to go through a process that's called projection. And what a projection means is a little bit of a physical term almost. Imagine that I had a light and the light is sort of shining down perpendicular to the surface of this principal component, then you can imagine that all of the data points are going to be sort of casting shadows down onto like a piece of paper if I put it there. Now my principal component looks like this. So I started out with two-dimensional data, but once I've projected it down onto the principal component, it's in one dimension, and it's going to look something like this. Now instead of being the blue circles, my data is going to be the black X's. I've turned it into a one-dimensional distribution. I've just taken the feature that I've made in this diagram and sort of turned it so that it's lying flat. What's it going to look like?